Now it's time to see if I can get some client server stuff going on. So I'm back on the MLS client so far, and I guess it would be a good idea to install some server 7.4.0 for just be sure. I know it should work in enforcing mode for the most part, but there are some things that are denied for RPM, so just to be sure I'll just do that. So it's basically install httpd, I guess. It's that's probably the best most simplest example, I guess, hopefully. And then 7.4 is 1. And then let's see if it's out of the running. Grab audit. It's running. So yeah, could start off by just seeing how if it runs and how it runs and stuff like that. So service httpd start, and that's running it, of course. It's early. And it seems to be starting. PS aux grab httpd. So the web server runs with the full MLS range clearance. Now I'm wondering whether it's easily possible to get it to run on a different range, on a different level. So nano etc rc d init d and then httpd. Not sure if L C 6, oh actually S 6, S 6, not sure if this is going to work actually. Let's just try that in permissive mode, because that's probably not gonna work anyways. Actually, let's try that in enforcing mode, but it's not gonna work anyways, I think. Invalid context. Because init rc is... So that's not gonna work, because for some reason init rc is not allowed. let's have a look at the policy. Web server. First, have a look at the web server. So Apache can be run. There's no support for MLS here, but yeah, the policy for well might be different because it's obviously running on system high or system low, system high. So this is probably not. Same from this perspective. Doesn't look like it is. So yeah, what initRC is actually able to transition. Wondering how should I do that? Let's see. It's not gonna work either. It's gonna run in it. And it's not even. So that's not gonna work. Change the policy too much. So how do I go about this? Doesn't do anything other than running in it. Yeah, see, it just doesn't. I guess I could create a wrapper script, but then the question begs to be asked is HTTP allowed to in advance with full range. See, everything runs. That's not needed. This is for new rule. In it, RC is not allowed. I'll search HTTPS. Ouch. So we have that. Here's Rentcon actually transitioning. Now, I'm not sure if that would be a good idea. To allow that, probably not a good idea, but that would at least take care of the easier part. Else I would have to probably change the policy. I would probably have to set up a range transition. So this would be the easy hack to get stuff to run on the security level, but yeah, then runcon in the initrc domain is kind of compromised. So yeah, that's a problem. And I don't know why the HTTPD executable file needs to be an entry point to initrc. Am I abusing initrc in that sense as well? But eventually does actually ends up running in initrc. So yeah, that's something not right. Man, runcon. So, it's actually you, system you, R, system R, T, HTTPD, T, and then I might actually see if it helps, what the effect is if I say compute before running it. Search and ABCTS 927. So compute create is in permission that, yeah, this seems a little bit better. Let's stop this. Let's edit that. This is an option. It's not a good option, but it's an option. So let's go with this out and try the following. This might just be super stupid. Maybe it's just really simple. For example, new row level S6. Let's see what is it here. Service HTTP spy. And then I search CTS 9 2. And it's still just running on that's just not gonna work, that's not gonna fly. And if I do this use GCICD and D star. It's to be star. That's weird. Can be allowed by setting the boolean allow bitrate. The fuck? So in order to see, needs to transition to HTTPD, but that's a constraint rule. So yeah, the constraint rule actually stays there, and the set exec rule as well, so that's just so fucked up. No matter how you look at it. But other than that, it seems fine. RPM to list HTTP. So it doesn't actually it does actually install file in HTTPD. So these are just some rules that I guess I should just add, although it would have been better to basically just modify the policy and set up a range transition to a particular range, but this works as well. It's a little bit simpler, but yeah, it's going to cause the init script domain to be a bit compromised, because I'm going to have to allow it to basically transition to different levels, and actually I could actually put a wrapper in between that. So that basically initrc runs some init daemon that actually takes care of only executing Apache in the proper domain. Basically in a script only for Apache. I'm just gonna hack around it, because this is not in the scope of this exercise. That's actually the case. So the command that I ran was just, I might as well just have started it directly. Let me see. Oh yeah, that's me, of course. What if I just run HTTPD and just get it over with like this? this works as well. And then I don't have to modify the shit too much. This isn't nice. Damn, it keeps spawning. How do I stop it? Signals to start. Okay, stop. It stopped. So yeah, I need this and okay start. And I need, let's just do that. I copy this and let's just do that from a normal though that might actually be a problem. Damn. That's because was I actually running them in it? Yeah, actually running in it. That's just bullshit. I need to run them in it. Yeah, this. Yeah, this is better. So let's just use that. Then what would be even better is to just create a policy for create a script and create a policy for that script, I guess. Although, yeah, I'm not sure if that's actually. So if that file script to use it is actually required or not, might be. Let's just add these two rules. They don't seem to be constraint violations, so let's just add that. So ls nano my HTTPD policy module, and then my HTTP, and then just add those two rules in. See, so we have sysadmin executing this one, and then transitioning. Might actually at some point actually also be constrained. Type HTTP exactly at HTTP to sysadmin. Yeah, this needs to be done properly, so I guess there's better ways, but probably not enough. Sweet coffee. Nice. Yeah, and this is probably not enough. Let's just stop it. it needs actually send the child terminated signal. That's actually one thing that you'll want to do in the father script. Well, yeah, the child terminated signal is that constraint, probably. And so but anyways, let's just add that, but then I got other options as well, so let's just add both of them, also that file descript, although here it is set to be constrained, but let's see what happens if I'm if I just run it from the level itself already without actually. Where are you? That is too. This is already there, so that can be just added. Make that as a module. And then let's just also take care of some of these directories. Now, one of the fucked up things is already that it's actually writing to temp. See? And that's going to be a problem. APR stand. What the hell is that? Betsy APR stand. Is there some way to run it? It's a function, isn't it? Oh, it's actually not. Well, yeah, it's. It's a function. CW doing. So the foreground shit ain't gonna happen. Damn, this just setting that shit up is pretty damn less for. Oh, I see. You just see. I see the image. Options, what are the options? I guess this might actually be. Options none. And then foreign. And but yeah, I'm still messed with that temp shit. Let's just try it again. No, it's not at all. Oh, yeah. That doesn't make this doesn't make sense. It's running though. Transition. This is a werent transition. So yeah, this makes sense. Level. The level S0, S6. Yeah, we have that temp shit that's denied. And some other stuff that's denied, but at least ignorance. Nano etc sysconfig. HTTP Actually, I can take this. Just add a port there. Ready. And it probably won't be able to serve anything yet. Init service IP tables restart. IP tables. And it's open. But yeah, IP header shell. It's not gonna actually be able to host anything as far as I know. Yeah, actually it can read down, so yeah, that's actually gonna work as well. See? Okay. So it seems we have the server up, so let's just copy this stuff over. Just for reference. Nano start HTTPD text. And then it's just new role level S6 S6, and then just run it. And then we don't have to specify level because we're already on that. And basically all we specified is a transition and an entry point or something like that. Less HTTPD. Oh my HTTPD. And yeah, some other stuff, child terminated signal, but not that many rules. But yeah, we should actually create a script for that and then actually allow admin to run that script and then allow that script those permissions, I guess. But this is a quick workaround. So what was I saying? Oh yeah, so I think basically now we should get to the point, to the example for netlabel. Now, let's see the date. This is pretty recent. Perhaps larger shortcomings is never. Yeah, okay. This is that example. So what it says here is full is Linux labels of loopback with netlabel and subsoap. So actually, this is actually what we're going to try, this loopback over the loopback, because yeah, the server is on the same machine as the client. So that's why I did, and that's basically the easiest part, I guess. Even though secret label, first of if you're going to try this on your own system, you might want to grab a copy of the git peercon server test tool that I've used for this example below instructions and then blah blah blah. Once you got everything to build and you verify that your SLinux and netlabel installation is working as you'd expect, you need to start off by configuring the SIPSO domains of interpretation DOI. For this example, we're going to create two DOIs, one using standard MLS pass-through type and the other using local connection only full. Don't forget. You can always check netlabel main page for information. Yeah. So see again. So value 2 local DOI add DOI 1 and 2. So here we have it. So on the local loopback we have a DOI of 2, and on the other interface a DOI of 1. Okay, let's just install that. Set enforce 0 yum install net label, and it's probably net label tools or something like that. Damn. Netlabel tools with an underscore. Jesus. That's annoying. That's annoying. So, and then let's just follow his examples. Let's see if that's configured appropriately. So we have pass through on interface 1 and the DOI 1, I guess, on the ETH 1, I guess, ETH 0, and this is on the loopback device, DOI value 2. Then the default. So after you've set up DOIs, you need to configure netlabel to send traffic using these DOIs. In our example, we're going to configure the system such that traffic sent to the local host on the loopback will use DOI 2. Yeah, I know. And the local only. Using the local only full as a Linux DOI, and traffic sent to that IP address, so basically ETH 0, we use DOI 1, the normal MLS only DOI. Don't forget that we first need to remove default on label mapping that so we can use address select. So the default on label mapping. So I guess he means this one here. That would make sense. So let's remove the defaults and then set up the, I guess it's basically everything, I guess, and label. I'm not sure what the hell that means, but let's just try it out. Then we have this one here. Addresses, I guess. Then we have the SIPSO DOI 2 for local loopback. And then we have this for the IP address, which is 192. I need to actually get that IP address. Sure. And then just change that to this one. friend list. So the loopback is set to DOI2, SIPSO version 4, the IP address of 192 is set to DOI1, and then all other addresses set to unlabeled. I guess. Let's just see if I can still access my website here. No, I can't. Nothing, no network connection works anymore. Just now totally ABC 1 2 3. Yeah, and let's just set that to S6. Oh, actually S6. Isn't it this working? It used to be okay, yeah. So that network connectivity is not gonna work because, well, it's unlabeled and that's prevented, I guess. Local host. And that's not really working either. So root ABC 1 2 3. Yeah, I keep the defaults. I don't want to set a level ID. Okay, so I'll search MABC GS recent. Then yes, I'll add either to allow. So we have user T receiving from unlabeled peer. Yeah, we need to actually. Unlabeled T. Yeah, so that's something we need to take care of. We need to actually label the pair, don't we? Oh, here we have HTTPD egressing to the loopback network interface. That's something we actually need to take care of. Here we have constraint violation. So, why isn't that discussed? When we connect, we saw similar type. When we connect, So it's 1216822, and what was the IP address again? 169. But it's still not working, and I have to connect because there's some permissions denied. But let's just see what the behavior now is, and then just use 1021 or 1020. But at least now we have that netlabel pair. I see, netlabel pair ingress. So yeah, we need to take care of these netlabel rules. We not need these netlabel pair rules, and actually HTTPD egressing to. And that's this symbol rule, so let's just add that man of my HTTPD T, and I can't actually copy that. Actually, grab net if, and then just my HTTPD. And then netlabel pair. But is it? Yeah, netlabel pair. And this is ingress. My HTTPD T. Okay, nano my HTTPD T. So yeah, these are the two rules that we have. This is basically allowing HTTPD to send out on the loopback network interface, and this is allowing netlabel pair T to get, so that's me, that's the client, I guess. Let's just see what happens if I add this type low netlabel T. And then netlabel pair T, and I'll probably need to import those classes net if, and then egress. User share Linux eval make file my HTTPD pp, and see module insert my HTTPD pp. Now let's see if this changes anything. problem loading page. House search MACTS 1026. Oh yeah, we have more rules. So we have netlabel PHT received from a node. Let's just get the netlabel PHTs and the HTTPDs again. Grab netlabel PHT. This one, my HTTPD T, now my HTTP. So this one is actually allowing it to receive from generic nodes. So I need to get the node type, node T type. And node receive from is probably a kernel object. And then just go all through those. As long as you just avoid the unlabels, you should be fine, I guess. Now I'm running. Okay, so that's six. Basically, you're connecting to a secret server on level six. So let's just try that out on a different level. So instead of we have a no read up, so we should go log in on S5, I guess, and see if that works. And that's reset. Let's just see what we get. Hopefully it's locked. So here we have, actually, that's not it. Yeah, this is not it. Damn it. Let's go all the way down and see if we can actually But this is not it. This is me connected to something else. Destination address, destination port, source 53. So this is DNS. That's the DNS. Yeah, it's not. Why can't I just get a this is it. This is part of it, I guess. Where we have the web server on 6, writing to a TCP socket on 5. I think this is it. This is actually showing that it can't write down. I guess. And what happens if I log in with my full clearance? So yeah, I'm going to log in on S5 again, but with my full clearance. And the connection was reset. Now let's just open a shell and go to new role L6 ABC123 and then wget 192.168.122.169 and that's 80. Let's see, that's probably already no route to host. 169 forbidden, and that's right, it's there's no index HTML. Not fine. But anyways, I'm getting my request back. So let's see how that looks. Well, that doesn't look anything, because that's not audited, that's just allowed. But anyways, I think this is basically how it's supposed to work. Now, I'm not sure if I can actually run a Firefox. That's probably not gonna work, because it can't actually connect to the system bus and stuff like that. So that's probably not gonna work. Firefox. Oh, it actually is working, isn't it? Yeah. So this should be a Firefox 1.1.1.6.8.1.2.2.1.6.9. But the connection was still reset. That's weird. Let's try this again, because this might actually be experience. Let's just exit here and exit again. Now we have this xterm and then this ID. We're on x6 and then just run xterm again. Close this one here. ID Firefox. It's weird that it does have it in memory and shit. 1.9.6.8.1.2.1. So yeah, it's still not connecting. But I am on. Right, ingress and labeled. That's all I get, is unlabeled. Jesus. I'm setting Damon. Let's just grab Firefox. Nothing. Damn. What the hell is going on? what the hell is going on here? So, now I'm volume monitor. Or volume, whatever that is. It's connected to 4713. This is 4713. This is unreadable. 4713. Pulse audio. Run to sock file. We have an ingress for that's also 4713. What the hell is that 4713? So weird. Lot of bullshit. That's on system high, unlabeled. That's weird. I'm not sure how that works, but it's probably just GNOME sitting in between. Firefox and it's all 4713, whatever that is. Unlabeled system high funk. I don't know what that means, but let's just see again if. So yeah, this is not going to work, even though it's on the same level as the web server. But if I run wget, it does work. 192.168.122.169, isn't it? We get an error forbidden. but I'm getting a response. That's not going to get locked because it's fine. This is not found, but that's where you get that not found error. So yeah, okay, so let's go back to XS6, but now it's Joe, and see if that works. It's kind of confusing. S6 and then full range C0 C1023. So yeah, this is not going to work. This is a local site. But this is not going to connect, that's obvious. 192.168.1.22.169. This is working fine. So yeah, that's basically MLS. This is a secret web server that can only be accessed. That just can only be accessed from the secret network, I guess. And even here it doesn't work, does it? No. This doesn't work. It just doesn't respond. So yeah, this is pretty much a secret web service, you could say. It can only access from level sensitivity level 6, and that's on the local loopback. Oh, actually, local loopback is full. Full MLS, but where was it? So yeah, if you want to actually do full, what is it? The POI. Full SLinux type, local connection, and full S. Then you actually need to label your. Get your notes and yeah, I guess your notes. There's a lot of questions remaining. So here, actually, the weird thing is, that this stuff shows as unlabeled. See, it shows as unlabeled, but that's actually a pair. So yeah, but here you have, but that's a pair. This is so weird how this is done. Because, well, it says unlabeled with object R. And that's just basically it's using the unlabeled initial set. Which maps to the object R role, but this is really not an object, a pair. It's really a subject because, well, as you can see, it's a source also, the pair. Here it's actually sending out to the local. Back. And I'm not sure why it's system high, why it's set to system high. This is this crazy, this is that volume control that's just bussing. This is it. This one here. This ingress from local loop, local network interface. This should probably be allowed. I might should just actually grab ingress. Grab ingress. Now it will allow. Yeah, this should actually just be allowed. But not that unlabeled stuff. So, make add user share as a limit deval. Oh. is in module I minus db. See if that changes anything. Reinforcing. So now it allows it on the local loopback as well. Add a rule that shows all on local loopback. Nano my HTTPD T. Damn it. Let's add an audit to allow rule. Audit to allow, or actually allow, and then the source is just the domain or netlabel pair. Netlabel pair. And the target is the low native. And then it's net interface, and then both actually everything. Let's just show everything. Actually, let's just ingress. Also, I'm gonna get into issues with classes that I'm not importing, and then this also. Audit allow netlabel pair. And then node 2. It is a node. And everything there. And we have everything required. Actually, we need to require the attribute domain. Attribute domain. And hopefully we can see what's going on there. Oh, search. MACTS recent and grab granted. Let's just go over these. So we have here user T is allowed to egress basically. Sent out within range, I guess, with to full clearance, I guess. Now we have an ingress here. HTTP is also allowed to do that. Yeah, I'm just wondering why I'm allowed to egress and ingress on the loopback interface that's actually on system low. And that's how that networking works. It's really weird. But I might actually be able to netlabel pair. See, it's also allowed to receive from nodes that are on zero. But the issue is that Apache is not allowed to write to sockets that are not on that level. So it still blocks, I guess. So now I'm on sensitive before. One, two, seven. It's not going to happen. You see that there's a lot, you just feel that there's a lot of shit going on in the background because it's getting slow. 1.2.2.1.6.9 and connection is reset because that's just not allowed. So unfortunately that Pulse Audio is now also those grants. We have denied receive unlabeled. That's 5.3. Sure, that's DNS. That was actually that site that starts when you open up Firefox, I guess. It's basically directs to some DNS name. Denied ingress. But this is no volume control. I don't know why it's connecting to 4713. I think it's looking for Pulse Audio on the network. So yeah, I can see that it works. I just don't ask me to explain how exactly this stuff works. And it's also because I'm getting distracted by all these other ABC denials. It's so annoying, that Pulse Audio, but you just can't tell it to shut up, I guess. Or yeah, you can tell it to shut up, but I seem to not be able to disable it. So yeah, secret website, I guess. Let's remove those grand rules. Yeah, no. My HTTPD. Alright, comment them out. Let's just as you manage. Network nodes, network interface, oh, it's interface list. As you manage interface. So yeah, you have to look back, and it's yes, but I can't actually change that. I think as you manage, what is it, interface, and then R. And then low, but that's not gonna happen because it's specifying a policy, I guess. It seems to actually happen. Yeah. So let's just see. So yeah, this is not gonna work. Let's just go back, load off, and go to back to S6. Yeah, S6, S15, C0, C1023. Takes a while. So, 1272. That works. But this 192.16. Yeah, it's also working properly. 1269. It's also working. Now go back. And now we have our network interface also set to S6, and it's still granted. But now if I do that from another level, then I won't actually be able to probably be able to egress and ingress from that network interface. Let's just try that as well. And yeah, so that's the same. S4, S15, and then C0, C1023. And now just have a look again. Unable to connect, but at least I'm not getting that same message as earlier. So yeah, here we have it, just denied egress and ingress from the loopback, because loopback is basically higher, so I can't actually read and see egress. This is main volume. But anyways, it's just not working. But now it actually just can't even get out. But even without this, when it wouldn't be able to get to the web server, because, well, the web server isn't allowed to write to sockets on different levels. So yeah, it's neat stuff, but yeah, it's complicated. It gets complicated because now yeah, you have to deal with identity based access control, role based access control, type enforcement, and then you'll also have to deal with multi-level security. And well, that works. How that works is also sometimes pretty complicated. But anyways, yeah, that's basically it. I'll just shut this down. I need to basically also do this with a web server from a remote site. But yeah, it probably works pretty much the same, I guess. Shut down. Oh no. MLS is cool. But yeah, there are some issues. Yeah, you just can't write down and read up. So yeah, that makes life just harder. So you can't actually use it on a normal desktop, because, well, then you can't actually write to your devices and stuff like that, because that would allow you to basically declassify information, unless you run on a Now, even if you run a system high, then you can't write a system low. And if you run on a low level, then you might not be able to read from the device. So, shakes. So, someone with really extensive knowledge of how MLS works should basically take a thorough look at the current state. For example, there must be a solution to get at least the sound little bit to work, I guess, at least for default users. Oh yeah, default users, users that are not actually running on a sensitivity other than on S0.